I'm Evelyn and welcome to my channel. I hope you're all having a wonderful day. So, we are finally continuing with my Seasons-inspired apartments. It's been a while since the last one. I think it's been a little bit over a month. And it was the spring-inspired one. Even though it was only for a single sim or a couple, I kind of feel like I should redo it and do it for a family instead, just because the other apartments will mainly be family or family apartments. So I don't know, let me know what you think about that, but we are continuing today and we are doing the summer inspired one. So I've been using a lot of stuff from Jungle Adventure game pack, and also what else, Laundry Day. There's a lot of stuff from Laundry Day too. I think City Living as well, of course City Living because it's an apartment, but also some of the items and Seasons of course. And I've also used a lot of stuff from the new download update that we got Thursday, which I was super excited about because it fits freaking perfectly with the stuff from Jungle Adventure and just like the whole vibe of this apartment, to be honest. So I was very, very excited about that. I did start this apartment sometime last week, but it just the update came Thursday and I was like, this is perfect, this is freaking perfect for this apartment. And I'm so I'm so happy. I started saying glad and I kind of want to continue saying happy, and then it kind of turn into Gladdy. I don't know what fully happened right there anyways, but I'm so happy that the whole like vibe of those items fit this apartment perfectly. English is kind of an issue today. I have not slept much, neither any of the days this week pretty much, so my brain is a little bit tired. English, it doesn't go very well when I'm tired, so I'm sorry for that, but that's just how that is. I will try to fight my way through this voiceover, but there will probably be a few mistakes here and there, and I hope that's okay. Don't butcher me in the comments, but anyways. So this is built in Uptown, and it is built in the Feng's old apartment. I am a little bit puzzled why this apartment is so huge and only two sims normally live in it, like standard only two sims live in it. I have no idea why, because it's like it's humongous. There are so many rooms in this apartment and I definitely feel like they could fit more than just two sims in there, but at the same time the things are also kind of wealthy, so why would they cut down on space when they have all this money? They can live in a big apartment just the two of them. So yeah, I totally get it that way, but other than that I'm a little bit like puzzled why they put them in this apartment and there's room for just two sims like standard. I've made room for two parents and a kid and a teen, and I don't think either the kid or the teen's rooms are too gender specific, so you can pretty much have anyone living in here if you want to. There is also a library on, or not a library, a study on the bottom floor along with this big, big kitchen, dining area, bar area, so on, and also a hallway. There are two bathrooms, which there also is in the standard apartment, I think, if I'm not mistaken. They got one like right at the entrance when you walk into the apartment, and one on the upper floor where the bedrooms are. And then also there is the big living room or living area, which is like open planned, or not open planned, but it's two stories. I don't recall. Sorry about that. Mezzanine? I don't fully recall what it's called, but they do have like an open room in that way, so all the windows in there in that end of the apartment look, I think it looks very good when you make it like that. It's like open across levels of the apartment. How do you say that? Across stories? I don't freaking know. But I do think it looks very, very good in this apartment when you make it open level like that, because you can, you know, there's a lot of light coming from through the windows. There are a lot of windows in the living area of the apartment, so I think it looks really, really good because of that. And yeah, I chose to kind of keep it that way. I think it's like that in the standard apartment as well, but it just looks really, really good to me. And I also put in that spiral chandelier that kind of goes across levels as well. It's like a split level chandelier kind of thing. It looks really, really good from the outside, so it's a little bit fancy for this apartment considering this apartment is so boho. But I thought it was okay. It's kind of the whole living room is a little bit dressed down, and then the the chandelier makes it a little bit more fancier again. So yeah. How are you guys feeling about the free content that we got Thursday? I haven't done a video since the content came out because I've just been busy with other things. But I do want to know what you guys think about it, because I am obsessed with especially the wallpaper. I think the wallpaper is freaking amazing and I can't wait to use it more. I've used it a lot in this apartment. I think I've used the white and gray swatch in this living area later on, and I've also used, what is it, one of the other swatches in both the parents' bedroom, and I've used one of the blue swatches in the child's bedroom, I think. I also tried to use one of the swatches in the teen's room, but it has this like wall mural thing. Wall mural, that is why it's called a okay, this mural on the wall, which is like a big painting you get from City Living, or you know, you can paint on it. I put that in the teens room, so they have like this huge decor or painting on the wall, kind of. You'll see that later on. I've done that before as well, but I really love doing that in apartments because there's so much space and it just takes up a lot of like wall space and just adds like beautiful touch with some art in the room. So I've done that with that room, and I thought it was a little bit too much to put the leafy wallpaper in there as well along with that mural, so I haven't used it in that room, but I've used it in basically, you know, every other room, and I think it looks freaking amazing. It's just so beautiful. I kind of wish we had gotten the same kind of wallpaper but without the bottom panels as well. That would have looked great, like just like plain leaf wallpaper. That would have been amazing. But I'm okay with it. I think it looks great. It's free as well. And it just, yes, we definitely needed something like that, because I love the ones we got in Parenthood or from Parenthood that are black and white. You know, the ones with the trees. So I'm so excited that we got some that you can get both green, but you can also get with like blue background or pink background, but you can also get a black and white, which is freaking awesome. So there's a little bit for every kind of room basically. I've also ended up using one of the plain swatches without the leaves on them for tomorrow's build, which, well, hopefully is coming up tomorrow. We will see. Otherwise it will be up on Monday. I'm having a few issues doing voiceovers these days because my boyfriend is home all the time, and you guys know, if you've watched my videos before, I just hate recording or doing voiceover or anything like that when he's in the house. Like, it just makes me feel super awkward. I can't relax because I have stage fright, and it just, the thought of someone just like constantly being able to hear me sit here and talk to you guys just makes me a little bit nervous, and I can't relax, and it gets all awkward and everything. So yeah, that's an issue for me. But I have tried to, you know, catch up on videos and stuff, so there is that. But yeah, I hope to have that one up tomorrow. Hopefully I'll have some free time alone up here upstairs to do a voiceover, but we will see, because the new World of Warcraft expansion came out. He's been playing a lot of computer because of that, so there is that. But I'm trying my best. But yeah, the tomorrow's build was actually requested kind of a lot, so I decided to just start another work in progress, because why not? I mean, I have 12, why not start another one? Why not go a little bit crazier? But yeah, I did start that, so I'm super, super excited to show you guys that once it's done. It's not completely done yet, but hopefully it will be done before tomorrow, and also with a voiceover and everything, because I really like how it's turning out. I did post a picture of it on my Discord channel. If you want to join the Discord channel, there's a link or an invitation link in the description down below, by the way. But I did post a work in progress picture on there, and it seemed like you kind of liked it, so I'm hoping that it'll be good. I'm hoping that the interior won't be, you know, extremely awkward or something. But so far so good, I think. But I've used one of the swatches from the new wallpaper, or off the new wallpaper, yeah, one of the swatches of the new wallpaper in that house, and I think it looks super cute. So yeah, I do realize that later on I kind of go back and change the leafy wallpaper that I used behind the TV and the fireplace to the original mint green one, and then I use the black and white swatch of the leafy wallpaper on the sort of white wall where the staircase is. And with the paintings, or it's not, because they're not really paintings, they're frames with like tapestry in them, sort of, but they do look a little bit, it's like a little bit over the top at that point, because there is this leafy wallpaper behind it, but I don't know, I felt like it was okay, kind of, because there is a lot going on in this apartment. There are a lot of patterns everywhere and a lot of colors, so I thought it would be okay, but I was looking at it when taking screenshots like, oh, that's a lot going on, right? There's a lot of different patterns right on top of each other, but I hope it's okay with you guys. It's not like, it's just me being very nitpicky with these smaller things when it comes to my builds, I guess, but yeah, I thought it was a little bit too much, but at the same time, I thought as well, it's okay, you know, we can deal with this. It's the same kind of situation right here, but because the colors on the tapestry blend in very well with the colors behind it, I think it's okay, at least, in this situation. But yeah, I do really, really like those tapestry paintings, or whatever you want to call them. I think they look great, and I'm so happy that we got new wall decor, and I wish we got more paintings still. I also freaking love that new plant. Like, what the heck? That plant is perfect. I've been wanting a plant like that. I don't even... Oh, yes. That plant gets me very excited. I don't know how to explain it. I just really love that plant. It's perfect. So yes, and it works in both like boho situations, but also in more modern environments, because you got the very plain vases as well, or vases, I don't know. Anyways, or pots, let's just call it pots. So you got the black, I think there's a brown and there's a white one, so they look very good in like more modern interiors, but there is also the more patterned ones, so I'm super, super, super excited for that plant. I don't know. You guys don't know. You guys don't, maybe you guys don't understand. I don't know, but plants make me very excited in the game, so yeah, there is that. So in here is the teen's room that I was talking about before, with the very, like, the long plain wall that I put a mural on. I think that mural looks so good in boho interiors. I think it looks really good on just like plain walls where you don't fully know what to do. You don't want to put shelves on them, but at the same time, you don't want there to be like this awkward bookcase next to the bed. So yeah, I think that mural looks, it's like, takes up a lot of space, and I think it looks beautiful. You can get a lot of like really great paintings if you make your sim paint on it, and then you can just like put stuff in front of it, and then hopefully they won't like deface it or anything, remove it during gameplay. I haven't actually playtested it like that, so I have no idea, but I hope not, hopefully. But I really like how it looks. There are a lot of great swatches of that mural, so yeah, definitely something worth checking out if you haven't done that already. I don't remember where I saw someone doing that first, but I'm pretty sure I saw it in a picture on Twitter at some point, like months and months ago. I have done it before in other apartments especially. I don't remember if I've done it in a room build, but I definitely have not done it in a house build yet, but maybe I will at some point. But then again, I haven't really done any boho houses, to be honest. I should probably do a boho house. What do boho houses look like? or bohemian house, as you call it. I don't know. We'll figure it out at some point. That would actually be kind of great, to be honest, so maybe I should do that at some point. Like a lot of flowers outside, or just like a lot of plants, like completely overgrown little cottage with some bohemian interior. Yes, that's what we want. I don't know, I kind of want to build a bohemian house now. This happens in like during some voiceovers. Also, by the way, that is the first time I've used that swatch of that rug. Never used it before. I've been wanting to use it for a while, the white one with the pattern on it from City Living, I take it. I've never used it before, but I've been wanting to use it, and I was like, this fits perfectly right here. This is like the perfect measurements. We're just gonna put it right there. You probably can't see it very well during gameplay, but it is there, and that's what counts. But yeah, now I kind of want to build that bohemian house. Let me know if you have any ideas what a bohemian kind of house would look like, because I don't know. Maybe it's more like a trailer kind of build. Okay, anyways, just let me know, or a caravan. Let me know if you have any ideas. I don't know, I just stopped brainstorming in the middle of my voiceover. This is the kids' bedroom, and I don't think it's very gender specific. You could have just like anyone living in here, pretty much. I do think the teens' room is mainly towards, like, it's definitely leaning towards girls mainly, but I do think you have anyone living in there as well. It's just, it's for a teen that loves music and also has a journal, and I don't know, it's just likes bohemian stuff, I guess. isn't afraid of like more colorful environments, or you know, stuff like that. So it's sort of the same thing for the child's room, except I really don't see anyone specific living in there, and when I did the teen's room, I didn't really have anyone specific in mind. mind either, but I do feel like in the end it mainly leans towards the girls' room. However, you could definitely have a boy living in there as well, at least in my opinion. So yeah. Anyways guys, let me know how you guys are doing. Are you enjoying your weekend? I know Saturday is pretty much over by now for some of you guys, and maybe if you're in Australia it's already Sunday, who knows. I can't really time zones. I'm fairly good at like European time zones and also American time zones, but anything east of Europe, I've been clueless, so I don't fully know. I think in Australia they're either 10 hours ahead of Denmark or 12. I'm not entirely sure, but it's probably already Sunday over there by now. But let me know how you guys are enjoying your weekend. Are you doing anything exciting, or have you done anything exciting, or are you just chilling? Is it bad being back at school, or are you enjoying that? Is it nice to see your friends again? So many questions, but do let me know in the comment section down below so I can get a little update from you guys. And yeah, that over there is the little study that I was talking about before. It's a little bit of a hobby room as well, because there is, I put in the bonsai tree, which I never use, but because it's a department and they don't have a terrace either, I didn't really know how to put in any gardening skill leveling items, so I decided to put the bonsai tree there. I don't actually fully know if that levels up gardening, but I think so. In my opinion, at least it makes more sense, but I'm not actually sure. But I also put in an easel so they can practice painting, and they got a computer so they can do different kinds of thing on there, and also a bookcase, because your Sims can level up pretty much any skill whatsoever through a bookcase, because they can just read. I don't really see how that makes any sense, because you don't really learn how to do stuff just by reading. You have to do as well, but it's the Sims, it's okay. So they do have that little hobby room over there, and this is the only bathroom that I am showing in this video. The other one looks pretty much like it. It is in the screenshots though, for a change. I usually only include one of the bathrooms in the screenshots, but this time around I decided to include both of them because they do have a few differences. They are quite big bathrooms, both of them, so I had a little bit of extra space to kind of do a lot of different stuff in there. So yeah, and I also put in washing machines, that's the one, in this bathroom as well, so they can do laundry as well if they want to. But you can just remove those if you don't like playing with laundry and put in something else, like another counter or something else like that. I just thought it would look really good in this bathroom if they did have the laundry machines. So yeah, because they get this like nice blue swatch that totally matches the wall paint here, so I thought that looked really, really good. I know it's a little bit darker than the rest of the rooms in the apartment, but I thought it would be okay. Also because I'm actually pretty sure that I'm using that blue one in the teens room, so there is kind of that coherence between those rooms at least. So yeah, as long as they match somehow, even though I still kind of want to go back to making the teens rooms especially, and also the children's room for that matter, like completely crazy compared to the rest of the builds. I kind of feel like I'm stuck doing the same color scheme over and over in every room, in every build that I do. Like these days, I just kind of want to go a little bit crazy, because you can add more personality that way, but we will see what I do in my future builds. But for now, I thought it would just be nice if both the teens room and also the kids room kind of just matched like the whole vibe of the entire apartment, so I kind of stuck to it this time around, but I will try to mix it up in my future builds. But we are getting into screenshots soon, so I'm gonna wrap up this voiceover now. I hope you like this build. You can download it off the gallery. My ID is EvelynYT, and you can also find it under the hashtag Evelyn or EvelynYT. It is uploaded as a room build, so all you do is download it and then you go to the apartment, which is listed in the description down below, and you just completely bulldoze everything, and then you place down the bottom part of this apartment, I think, with BB move objects on, and then you go to the top floor and do the same, and everything should be in its place. Just remember to bulldoze the apartment as like the standard apartment first, because otherwise it would just end up looking very, very strange. That is all. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to like, subscribe, and all that good stuff if you did, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye!